Continuing our exploration of how AI can elevate spiritual intelligence and personal well-being, here's the prompt from today. Dear AI, in this case Perplexity Pro, I would like your help in formulating a general theory of creation and evolution of the cosmos with the following points. Creation begins from the ground state of pure consciousness. Pure consciousness is without form, without cause. It is infinite, spaceless, timeless, irreducible, fundamental. It is also a matrix of infinite possibilities, non-local correlation, and infinite evolution. It's the source of all experience in every sentient being, and it expresses itself as the source of all experience in every sentient being and in experiences that are species specific. These experiences come from the matrix of qualia. Qualia are qualities of experience, and the ground state differentiates into species specific qualities of experience and biological organisms, which themselves are differentiated from the matrix of qualia and project their own species-specific experiences of the world corresponding to the biology of the species and the specific experiences of the worlds that correspond to the biology of the species. This includes minds, brains, projected worlds that correspond and correlate with the species-specific brains, which reflect the neuroplastic nature of the brain, which is from the collective matrix of mind, and in essence follows pure consciousness, modifying itself into species-specific minds and their corresponding sensory worlds in the human matrix of qualia. And then I also said the collective brain, interpersonal biology, reflects the collective conditioned mind. And as we take our next leap in evolution, we will jump from human to meta-human, taking quantum leaps of creativity and unleashing and awakening. And we'll see the unleashing and an awakening of dormant potentials, including extrasensory perception, supernormal powers, non-local dormant potential, teleportation, quantum leaps of creativity, etc. New meaning, new context, new relationships, and new stories projected as the new universe. Okay, as you know, I've been accused of purveying pseudo-profound bullshit. But I did say in the end, help me formulate this general theory of creation and give me any philosophical or scientific support for that. So here we go, the general theory of creation and evolution. Here's the answer. It seems like you're interested in formulating a general theory of creation and evolution of the cosmos. Your theory proposes that creation begins from the ground state of pure consciousness, which is formless and infinite. This pure consciousness is the source of infinite possibilities and is responsible for the differentiation of species-specific qualities and the appearance of the world corresponding to the species. Not bad, actually. According to your theory, biological organisms are a differentiated matrix of qualia, qualities of experience, and project species-specific appearances of the world. The minds and brains of sentient beings reflect the collective matrix of mind, and the human matrix of qualia gives rise to basic sensations, perceptions, feelings, and thoughts. You also mentioned that the collective matrix of human context, meaning, and stories can evolve through a process similar to natural selection with the help of technology and large language models, and I did ask that too. This collective matrix can expand, leading to a quantum leap in human potential and the awakening of dormant sensory perceptions and supernormal powers. Your theory suggests that this leap will result in a new universe where what was once considered science fiction becomes science reality. It implies the possibility of teleportation, quantum leaps of creativity, and the projection of new meanings and stories. While your theory is based on philosophical and scientific hypotheses, it is important to note that it may require further validation, exploration, experimentation to be considered a comprehensive theory. It combines elements of consciousness, biology, evolution, and technology, and opens up possibilities for new understandings of the cosmos. It goes on, it's fascinating to consider these ideas and the potential they hold for our future. Science and philosophy continue to evolve, and with further exploration, we may gain deeper insights into the creation and evolution of the cosmos. Then I asked it to give me a visual. Here's the visual. Metahuman visual. Okay, according to the theory you presented, the proposed source of infinite possibilities in creation and evolution of the cosmos is the ground state of pure consciousness. This pure consciousness is described as formless, infinite, without cause. It is considered to be the fundamental matrix from which all possibilities emerge. Pure consciousness is believed to be the source of non-local correlation, unpredictability, and infinite correlation. It is the matrix that allows for the differentiation of species-specific qualities and the projection of species-specific appearances, species-specific experiences, leading to infinite correlations. And it also allows for the infinite interplay and interdependence of various phenomena, leading to infinite correlations between different elements of the cosmos. It is based on the idea that pure consciousness is unbounded potential and is also has inherent creative intelligence. Pure consciousness believed to possess creative intelligence, which allows for spontaneous and unpredictable expressions. It is not bound by deterministic laws or predetermined patterns. Instead, it operates in a manner that is beyond our conventional understanding of cause and effect, leading to unpredictability and novelty in the unfolding of the cosmos. It also offers the idea of emergence of complexity. As the evolution of the cosmos unfolds, it allows for complexity, new meaning, new possibilities, and new interactions as a result of the profound interconnectedness and unity between consciousness and the fabric of reality, opening up new possibilities for understanding the nature of consciousness and its relationship to the universe. In summary, the potential implications of non-local correlations for the study of space-time are profound. They challenge fundamental conventional scientific dogma at the moment. Non-local correlations also challenge causality in the context of time. If events can be correlated or influenced across vast distances simultaneously without a direct causal relationship, it raises questions about the directionality of cause and effect. It challenges the linear one-way flow of cause and effect that is typically associated with the arrow of time. Okay, what else did it say? Further research and investigation into non-local correlations can potentially revolutionize our understanding of space-time and the interconnected nature of the universe. Okay, well, that's basically it. And we have a new theory, a general theory of a general theory of creation and evolution of the cosmos based on the idea that consciousness is the ontological primitive of the universe and matter, energy, information are human constructs for fundamental activities in consciousness, which is the generation of sensations, sense perceptions, images, feelings, and thoughts that don't ingest an external world, but project as the body, the mind, and what we call the external world, and recycle and evolve to higher levels of creativity, complexity, in a never-ending horizon of evolution. Let me know if you find this interesting.